Calling all lightworkers across the planet Mother Earth. We have work to do. There are some atrocities happening in the Amazon rainforest down south as I speak. Spread this message like wildfire. Share this video with your friends and family and fellow lightworker friends so we can spread awareness and bring the power back to the people and make this world a better place with the consciousness of love and compassion for all beings. Take action now on your higher purpose. If not now, I don't know when is a better time. If you've been waiting for a sign, then here it is. If you've been waiting for a reason why to do the work that you're here to do, then this is your sign. If you're here as the cleanup crew to clean up the mess that's been created here, to leave the planet better than when we arrived, this message is for you. Now let's get into the nitty-gritty details of what's going on to our beloved Mother Earth down south. In the Amazon rainforest, more than 72,000 fires happened this year in 2019. What? This is an 80% increase over the same period last year. The president of Brazil, Bolsonaro, blames the Amazon rainforest fires on the NGOs. There's no evidence to his claim. Environmentalists called this charge sick and pitiful. They say the real cause is Bolsonaro's sick policies, let's be honest, which have dismantled protection of the rainforest. An 88% increase in forestation was measured in June of this year compared to last year. The indigenous people of the Amazon are suffering more than you can imagine right now. And it's not just a few small villages. There are hundreds of thousands of indigenous people that live in the Amazon. These are innocent brothers and sisters who have been living there for thousands of years. These are people who are tapped into their beloved lands and the true consciousness and spiritual presence that exists in all things. Listen to the wisdom of the elders of the Amazon jungle. Quote, "It's destruction. All of these trees had lives. They all needed to live." Quote, "I think about the future generation, our children and grandchildren. We will not be breathing the same air we breathe today. If this land is not preserved, the people living here, along with everyone else, will cease to exist." Quote, "We have resisted over the years when the invasion started to arrive. With each passing day, the destruction worsens. What is being done here is an atrocity against us. It's a blight on life. The Amazon produces 1/5 of the world's total oxygen, so it's basically the lungs of Mother Earth. I think it's obvious and logical to conclude that if the world's lungs are being attacked and mistreated and abused, so are our lungs, so are our bodies. What is harmful to Mother Earth is harmful to humanity. The Amazon is also one of the world's greatest defenses for climate change. Most of the fires are occurring in the areas where there are massive increases in deforestation, which likely could be for more animal agriculture, which actually is one of the greatest causes of greenhouse gases that we face in the world today. But don't believe me, do your own research and look it up. Watch the documentary Cowspiracy or What the Health on Netflix. Now, like little children that aren't being supervised by their caretakers, these ignorant corporate elites are destroying large areas of natural rainforests in order to create land to raise animals that use up tremendous amounts of water and energy so they can slaughter these animals for the mass consumption. Agriculture, forestry, and other land use adds up to more than 24% of the world's global greenhouse gas emissions. Yet even more important is the damage that deforestation does to the overall biosphere. The corporate news outlets, aka the lamestream news, won't share this information. Make no mistake, these atrocities, which are likely being performed by major corporations, will go down in history as crimes against humanity and against the earth. And make no mistake, justice will be served. As advice for the people, think twice before you think about eating another steak or hamburger. This is serious and no joke. Consider changing your dietary habits if you want to decrease deforestation and increase the likelihood of our future generation's survival. Listen to this. Only 1 pound of beef takes 1,799 gallons of water or 350 toilet flushes of water. This is the drinking water for the cattle and to water the land, etc. And later on, the cattle are just slaughtered. Billions are killed every single year. If we actually all knew on a collective level what was required to consume these animal products and the damage that this process is doing to the planet, we would stop it immediately. Everything starts with awareness. So spread awareness, vote with your daily decisions and actions. On a more positive point of view, we are in the era of the Great Awakening. Believe it or not, the era of corporate greed and corruption is dying as they give their last efforts. We must first see all of the atrocities that are occurring and have been occurring for a long time. We must view what's happening with our own two eyes so that global awareness and global sanity increases. So policies change, so negative leaders are kicked out, and so justice is served. I want to close out with some deeply positive and inspiring wisdom from indigenous elders of our beautiful world. In 1986, Lee Brown of the Salish tribe at the Continental Indigenous Council said, "At the beginning of this cycle of time, long ago, the Great Spirit came down and he made an appearance and he gathered the people of this earth together. They say on an island, which is now beneath the water, and he said to the human beings, 'I'm going to send you to four directions and over time I'm going to change you to four colors. But I'm going to give you some teachings and you will call these the original teachings. And when you come back together with each other, you will share these so that you can live and have peace on earth and a great civilization will come about.'" According to the story, a leader will not be the one who is the loudest, the most successful, or has the support from most of the elite groups. Leaders will be those whose actions are most aligned with the benefit of all, and those who have demonstrated wisdom and the courage to do the right thing. Grandfather William Kamanda from the Circle of All Nations prophecy of the seven fires of the Anishinaabe says, "In the time of the seventh fire, a new people would emerge. They would retrace their steps to find the wisdom that was left by the side of the trail long ago. Their steps would take them to the elders, who they would ask to guide them on their journey. If the new people remain strong in their quest, the sacred drum will again sound its voice. There will be an awakening of the people, and the sacred fire will again be lit. At this time, the light-skinned race will be given a choice between two roads. One road is the road of greed and technology, without wisdom or respect for life. This road represents a rush to destruction. The other road is spirituality, a slower path that includes respect for all living things. If we choose the spiritual path, we can light yet another fire, an eighth fire, and begin an extended period of peace and healthy growth," end quote. There will come a day when people of all races, colors, and creeds will put aside their differences. They will come together in love, joining hands, in unification to heal the earth and all her children. They will move over the earth like a great whirling rainbow, bringing peace, understanding, and healing everywhere they go. Many creatures thought to be extinct or mythical will resurface at this time. The great trees that perished will return almost overnight. All living things will flourish, drawing sustenance from the breast of our Mother Earth. Now in the Navajo Hopi prophecy of the whirling rainbow, it says, quote, "The great spiritual teachers who walked the earth and taught the basics of the truths of the whirling rainbow prophecy will return and walk amongst us once more, sharing their power and understanding with all. We will learn how to see and hear in a sacred manner. Men and women will be equals in the way Creator intended them to be. All children will be safe anywhere they want to go. Elders will be respected and valued for their contributions to life. Their wisdom will be sought out. The whole human race will be called the people, and there will be no more war, sickness, or hunger forever." Unlike what Wikipedia falsely claims, that this comes from a book called Legend of the Rainbow Warriors, the prophecy is actually ancient wisdom that has been passed down from generation to generation through oral history. Maybe oral history is more accurate than the official history. Please spread this message to your friends and those you care about, those you love. Always remember, love wins. Subscribe to this channel if you would like to see more inspiring videos like this. Much love to you and your family and your loved ones at this time. Peace and love to all beings across the planet Earth. Bye for now.